This is practice number 9, so we got 8 under our belt. First time today that we have full pads. So we've had a lot of installation days, a lot of teaching. I've had really good work, been very happy with that, but today is the first day that we're I did.
How did the football coach?
Well, I'm kind of a basketball guy. I've been to probably 10 games this year. Regardless of what my career is. I am kind of a basketball guy. That was a phenomenal game. It really was. It was sad to see our season come to an end. Illinois was pretty good. I think we would all agree with that. Shoot that well behind the three-point line, you're probably going to win a lot of games. But great season for Hugs. And, Carter and Miles. Obviously, sad to see their careers come to an end. But it was a great game.
Last couple weeks, you've gotten pretty much what you wanted to out of the learning process and technique.
Our installation stuff's over. Okay, so for the remainder of spring here today, the remaining, I guess, would be 6 practices, will be more situational type stuff. There'll be 3 scrimmages, and then a couple of the other days will be, just kind of teaching days off of the scrimmages. And then we'll have a couple other periods, a couple other practices that will be purely situational stuff. So, focus on critical downs today, focus on at least some 2-minute stuff. So it's been good. I've liked the process of where we're at. I think we got an idea of what we got, got to put them in live situations, one to see how they respond and how they react. But we got to teach these situations as well, so we'll be able to teach off of it as well.
How is Will progressing, and what is his status at this point?
Who?
Will Greer. I mean, how is he?
Yeah, he's our starting quarterback, so his status is pretty set in stone. He looks like a 5th-year quarterback to me. Second year in this system, and much more comfortable. His timing with the guys is as good as I've seen. So, from a the quarterback perspective, it's as good as anybody in the country.
Do you feel like that second year for some of these guys is really when it takes off?
Yeah, quarterback wise, yeah. Obviously, I've been here for more than 2 years, but with Jay calling the plays and a new O-line coach, there were some different things that we were doing, being able to have experienced guys second year in the system is going to be critical for next year.
And you're a new analyst?
Yeah, it's a familiar face. Familiar last name. Got my name of Ryan Nealon. I thought he was going to be a doctor. He was a good, obviously comes from a coaching background. When I coached him for 2 years, he was this quiet 4.0 student, that played hard when he played. But I always thought he was going to be a doctor perform surgery on people and stuff like that. But couldn't get the coaching thing out of his blood. He's been a graduate assistant for a couple of years, and he's a real smart kid. In those analyst positions, it's critical to have a lot of sense, and he's got plenty of that. So I'm anxious to see what he brings to the table.
He'll be performing surgery on your opponents now. Huh?
We'll be performing surgery on our opponents. That's a great way of putting it. And that's the first thing I said. He goes, "What's the job?" And I go, "Well, you got to study the opponent and give us as much information as you can." So he's going to do that. But then there is an analytics side to it as well, as far as self-scouting and doing specific studies, and he's going to be great at that.
Gary mentioned the energy that T.J. Simmons brings. Can you hear him?
Probably.
So that's an all
he's the one running around over on that other side. But, he does bring a lot of energy. He's made some plays, too, though.
also said a great studier of the game. Really takes it as a professional.
Yeah.
At this stage.
Yeah. He's a sophomore. The kid's got 3 years of eligibility. He looks like a pro. And he acts like one too. I hope he plays like one. That'd be nice as well.
How's Giovanni taking to it?
He's up and down. You know, he's still learning. But you know, that's an interesting spot that we haven't had since probably Tyler Hope, which is one of these ex-players that we got here. But, you know, that position, the receiving aspect of it comes natural to him. He's working hard at the blocking aspect of things, being in the box, being a fullback, being a tight end. He's got a good frame, but the receiving stuff's easy to him. But to be a complete player, he's got to continue to get better at the blocking aspect of it. We do have a bunch of former players. Alumni weekend, former player weekend, got probably, you know, their families, a lot of the families are here as well, so there's about 50 ex-players at this point. First time we've done it, that's not a part of the spring game, so it's been a big thing so far.
Tony Gibson mentioned tackling is key. Are you anxious to see how that goes today with first line contact?
Yeah, because we haven't done it yet. You know, we've really attacked the basics of tackling. You know, there's a lot of things that can be taught from tracking the ball carriers to fitting the ball carriers, but now it's going to see if we get them on the ground. So, you know, I'm really anxious. The next time I talk to y'all, I have a little bit better idea of how these guys respond to, what's the first real football that was played. All right.